Welcome to the Leaf Life Lab. Here we are going to investigate the role of light in producing the oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. And for this experiment, we're going to need our usual transparent glass, a little bit of water, a tap water will go well, will do well, a smallest drop of the liquid soap, sodium bicarbonate, also known as baking soda, the leaves, of course. In this particular case, we need we will use spinach. The fresher, the better. We already prepared the small pieces. Yes. Also, we're gonna need a glass stick to mix the soap and the water. A spoon, a syringe with cell, and a source of light. Some powerful source of light. Well, the best option, of course, is a sun, but in case of a cloudy weather, we can use a flashlight, for example, but not an LED, because the wavelength of light produced by LED is not the same that plants use in photosynthesis. The first step is to pour water into the glass. The usual tap water, no, not mineral, not carbonated, just nice water. So, then we will add some sodium bicarbonate to the glass. And we do this in order to produce the source of the carbon dioxide for our leaves. So mix it a little bit so it will dissolve there. Yes. And now we have to decrease the surface tension of the water so leaves can drown. And for this purpose we use the soap, just a tiny drop. And just a little bit, yes, we don't need any bubbles there. Just mix it a little bit, and now we will take a small pieces of the leaves, the ones that we prepared, and like few of them, 5, 4, something like that, and place them into the syringe. Very good. And now we will fill the syringe with water from our glass. We don't need much. That's very good. So push the pump a little bit. And now we have to get rid of all the bubbles of the gas inside of the syringe. So For this, we have to close the hole on the top of the syringe and pull the pump down. So it decreases the pressure inside the syringe, so all the gas goes out. And when all the pieces of leaves are drowned on the bottom of the syringe, it means that the gas, the oxygen, is out. So it may need a few repeats, but you will see it when the leaves are down on the bottom. So now, as you can see, they are down, they are in the bottom, so we can pour everything from the syringe to the glass. And now our leaves are drowning to the bottom of our glass. And the next step is the most difficult step of our experiment, it's the waiting. We will need a few minutes to leaves to get the oxygen from the light, from the air, and float back to the surface. But for this, we're going to need the light. So we don't have any sun here, unfortunately, so we're going to use the flash. It may take some time, but as I already told, but it's really worth waiting. Fortunately, we have prepared, so you don't have to wait with us. The other glass was standing out of the window, and the leaves started going up, rising up to the surface, and one have already reached it, the surface, which means that it has enough oxygen to float. To float up, because the density of oxygen is way lower than the density of water, of course. Right. So the experiment is successfully over, or is it actually? Because you know, it's just a base. We just give you the start. You can improve it the way you want. You can put your glass into the dark place, into the shadow, and observe what will happen. So, you can put different glasses into the different light source, under the different light sources, and check it out which one works better. It's up to you. And what is the role of the light in the photosynthesis? Can you answer right now? That's it.